Hello. Now we're going to look at styles. Styles are essentially design tools you have to control how your site looks as a single unit overall. So the background color of your pages, the typography you're using across the site, how close or far together your different content elements are, and so on. So to access the style menu, we're going to click on this half moon icon on the top right side of the screen. You'll notice that you immediately have this kind of preview of your selected styles or currently implemented styles, which includes your background, your accent color, and your fonts. I'm going to go ahead and start with typography, and then we'll go through colors and layout quickly as well. And you have options to change your text, your links, your headings, and your buttons. We're going to start with headings. That's why I have this laid out here with the different headings in front of us so we can see how it looks. And you'll notice with headings, you can change something about all the headings at once, or you can change individual headings. Because you generally want them to look different from each other, we're going to look at individual heading settings, starting with the H1. Now, you can do a lot of things to differentiate your headings. You can change colors. You can change kind of this appearance or weight of the fonts. You can change the letter spacing to make it drag out a little bit more versus feeling more compressed. And if you have longer headings or titles that you're going to be using, you can play with the line height and control how much space kind of exists between them. You can also play with fonts. You don't want to overdo it with different fonts on your site. You don't want to use 5 to 10 different fonts because it makes it really hard to read and kind of have any level of consistency. We recommend probably choosing 2 fonts. I've always liked choosing 1 serif and 1 sans serif, which you can see are H5. It does not have those little tails on it, whereas these other ones have those little tails on the tops and bottoms of the letters. But I think just choosing 2 that look good together is what you're going for and offer a little bit of contrast. So let's say we're going with sans serif. And you can see that that looks different than these. That thinned it out a little bit, so I can adjust the weight. And then I might decide I actually do like that serif font a little bit better. So you can change all those aspects in the font itself, at the heading level, at the individual heading level, or for all the headings. Now let's go back, let's look at colors. Colors gives you a few different options. We're going to jump back into headings. Again, you can adjust for all of them or for individuals. You can use the theme palette here, or you can click on this kind of tile that tells you the foreground that it's using right now. It's telling you it's using the foreground color from the palette. You can click on this tile to choose a custom color. So say if I wanted it to be a bright pink, I could do that. I could also just drag it down and make it a black or a dark gray. Again, just a little bit of contrast is all you really want, but you have full control over that. You also have the ability to add a background color if you wanted more of a bar kind of effect behind the type. You could do something like a white background. You could do a mint background or a black background, or if you felt like it, you could go with a gradient. You could play with something like this. Or you can use some of the other ones that are available, or you can manually configure it if you want. If you ever choose something you don't like, you can look for that clear option to just get rid of it. Finally, we're going to look at the layout options, which basically control the width of your content area, which is going to keep it kind of centered and kind of within the screen, max width versus min width kind of thing. We can control the padding, which is how much space your site has from the actual browser. And then, or the blocks have from the edge of the site, I should say. And then we can also look at block spacing, which is going to control what it sounds like, how much space exists between each of the blocks that you add. Now, if you're trying to create like a really tight layout with lots of things in it and you want things more like a tiled effect, like I think of little mosaic tiles that are really close together, you can shrink this down. If you're trying to create more of a spacious effect, I think of like a walkway for an outside patio or like a stone path where there's a little bit more space, you can crank it up. And the best thing to do is to play around with these when you have kind of your content on the page so you know how it looks and it make sure it's going to work for the content that you need. So that's the basics of styles. You can get into the block settings later. Play around, find the design you want, and reach out with any questions.